Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is biologically important nucleotides. This is a very important short note in university examination. Biologically important nucleotides mainly includes AMP, GMP, CMP, UMP and TMP. These are the important nucleotides. The most important function of this nucleotide is they are incorporated or they are monomer of nucleic acids. There are two types of nucleic acids, deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid, that is DNA and RNA. They are composed of nucleotides or they are composed of or they are made up of nucleotides. Nucleotides nucleotide it is made up of sugar molecule. This is ribose sugar. This is a ribose sugar. When it lacks oxygen at the second carbon, this is the first, second, third, fourth and fifth carbon. When it lacks oxygen at the second carbon, it is known as deoxyribose. This is a deoxyribose. When it is attached with nitrogen base, when it is attached with nitrogen base, it is known as nucleoside. This structure, it is known as nucleoside. When it is esterified, this fifth carbon, when it is esterified with phosphate, it is known as nucleotide or nucleoside monophosphate. Nucleotide or nucleoside monophosphate. When it is again esterified with phosphate, when there are two phosphate group, it is known as, this structure is known as nucleotide diphosphate. And when it is esterified with three phosphate group, it is known as nucleoside triphosphate. Got it? Sugar plus nitrogen base, it is known as nucleoside. When one phosphate is attached, it is known as nucleoside monophosphate or nucleoside 5' monophosphate. When it or nucleotide, sugar plus nitrogen base plus phosphate, it is known as nucleotide. When two phosphates are attached, it is known as diphosphate. When three phosphates are attached, it is known as nucleoside triphosphate. Okay. There are two types of bases, purine bases and pyrimidine bases. Purine and pyrimidine bases. Adenine and guanine, these are the purines. Adenine and guanine, these are the purines, while cytosine, Thymine, it is present in DNA, and uracil, it is present in RNA. This cytosine, thymine and uracil, they are pyrimidines. So there are two types of bases. Depending upon these bases, these nucleotides, they are named as when the nitrogen base is adenine, the nucleoside is known as adenosine and nucleotide is known as adenylate. adenine, adenosine, adenylate. This adenylate, it is also known as 5' AMP, adenosine monophosphate. Second is the guanine. Its nucleoside is guanosine and nucleotide is guanylate. Third one is cytosine. Its nucleoside is cytidine and nucleotide is cytidylate. Then thymine, thymidine, thymidylate. Uracil, uridine, uridylate. This is nitrogen base. This is nucleoside. This is nucleotide. Okay. This is monophosphate. When it is diphosphate, it is ADP, and when it is triphosphate, it is ATP. Adenine is the nitrogen base. Adenosine is the nucleoside. Adenylate or 5' adenosine monophosphate is a nucleotide. It is a diphosphate, that is adenosine diphosphate, adenosine triphosphate. Similarly, guanosine diphosphate, guanosine triphosphate. Cytidine diphosphate, cytidine triphosphate. Thymidine diphosphate, thymidine triphosphate. Uridine diphosphate and uridine triphosphate. So these are the important nucleotide which helps in the formation of nucleic acid, that is DNA and RNA. Thymine, it is found in DNA. It is methylated pyrimidine, while uracil, it is found in RNA. Adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine, they are found in DNA molecule. Adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil, they are found in RNA molecule. So these are the important bases which are component of DNA and RNA. Okay. Apart from these, as a constituent of nucleic acid, they are also having another functions. For example, second important function. This is ribonucleic acid. When they are incorporated in the DNA or in DNA, they have deoxyadenosine monophosphate, deoxyguanosine monophosphate, deoxycytidine monophosphate and thymidine monophosphate. When they are in the DNA, our DNA is composed of deoxyadenylate, guanylate, cytidylate and thymidylate. Got it? Now the second important function of nucleotide is they act as a coenzymes. Coenzymes means they are non-protein, organic, low molecular weight, dialyzable substance associated with enzyme action. Coenzyme, definition of coenzyme is non-protein, organic, low molecular weight, dialyzable substance associated with enzyme action. Some nucleotides, they are derivative of vitamin B complex. They are known as coenzyme. For example, NAD, NADP, FAD, coenzyme A. NAD, NADP, they are derived from niacin. FAD, it is derived from riboflavin. Coenzyme A, it is derived from pantothenic acid. They act as a coenzyme. example, this NAD, NADP, this NAD, it is a coenzyme in lactate dehydrogenase reaction, enzyme reaction catalyzed by lactate dehydrogenase or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. NADP, it is important in HMP shunt. Then FAD, it is important in TCA cycle and beta oxidation of fatty acid. Then coenzyme A, it is important in various reactions including pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. Remember, one enzyme which requires 5 coenzymes, that is pyruvate dehydrogenase complex or alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase complex. These two enzymes requires 5 coenzymes, that is NAD, FAD, coenzyme A, thymine, pyrophosphate and lipoic acid. Lipoic acid. This is the important MCQ. So these are the some examples of coenzyme. These are some coenzymes which are nucleotides. Nucleotides act as a coenzyme. So this is the second important function of nucleotide. They act as a coenzyme. Now coming to the third important function of coenzyme, that is they act as a second messenger. Nucleotides act as a second messenger. Now coming to the third important function, that is second messenger. Some nucleotides, for example, cyclic AMP and cyclic GMP, they act as a second messenger. Cyclic AMP, it is a second messenger in hormone action, in classification of hormone on the basis of mechanism of action. It belongs to group 2A. It is important or a second messenger in the reaction or hormones like glucagon, epinephrine, parathyroid hormone, etc. Then cyclic GMP, it belongs to group 2B. It is important in the hormone, or it is important in the mechanism of hormones. For example, nitric oxide and atrial natriuretic factor. So third important function of nucleotide is they act as a second messenger in the hormone action. Mechanism of hormone action. Then fourth one is the metabolic intermediates. Some nucleotides, they are metabolic intermediate. For example, UDP glucose, uridine diphosphate glucose, it is important in glycogen metabolism. Glycogen metabolism. While CDP, cytidine diphosphate acyl glycerol, CDP, it is important in phospholipid metabolism. Phospholipid metabolism. Okay. Some nucleotides, they act as a methyl carrier. Methyl group donor or methyl carrier. For example, S-adenosyl methionine SAM. It is a universal methyl group donor. It is an important MCQ. S-adenosyl methionine. Then some nucleotides, they act as a high energy compound. For example, ATP. ATP is known as energy currency of cell. And in some reaction, GTP is also utilized. Okay. Hydrolysis of one phosphate bond in ATP gives 7 calories per mole. So it is a important high energy compound. It is a energy currency of cell. It is important in cellular reaction. So some nucleotide, they act as a high energy compound. They are important in synthesis of glycoproteins. Nucleotides, they are important in synthesis of some glycoprotein. That is UDP glucose, UDP galactose, mannose, neuraminic acid, they helps in the synthesis of glycoprotein. So these are the some important functions of nucleotides in our body. They are building blocks molecule, or they are monomer in the nucleic acid synthesis, that is synthesis of DNA and RNA, which has important function in our body. For example, protein synthesis, genetic information, they carry genetic information, they store genetic information, they transfer genetic information. That's why it is important function. Followed by, they are coenzyme NAD, FAD, coenzyme A, NADP, they are coenzyme in various reaction. Then they act as a second messenger, cyclic AMP, cyclic GMP. They are metabolic intermediates, UDP glucose, CDP. They are important in carbohydrate and lipid metabolism. Then some act as a methyl group donor, that is S-adenosyl methionine. Some are high energy compound, for example, ATP. They are important in the glycoprotein synthesis. Apart from this, they regulate metabolic reactions. For example, cyclic AMP, it is important in metabolic reaction. Okay, so these are the important functions of nucleotides. This is a very, very important short note in university examination. This is all about nucleotides, their functions. Synthetic nucleotide, it is a important topic. It is also a important short note. Synthetic nucleotides, which are used in the treatment of cancer, which is used in the treatment of AIDS, it is used in the treatment of gout. Some synthetic nucleotides are 5-fluorouracil, mercaptopurine, then azathioprine, then AZT, azetothymidine, dideoxyadenosine, allopurinol. These are the synthetic nucleotides. Okay, so these are the some important nucleotides and their function. Keep watching. Thank you.